In January this year, President Yoweri Museveni launched the drilling of oil development wells at Kingfisher Development Area on Lake Albert in Chikube District. However, drilling stalled due to the absence of a waste management facility. But work resumed recently after Luwero Industries and China Oil HBP Services and Technology Corporation Limited set up a waste management facility.
The project itself has four pads, which will give us a total of 31 wells, where you have 20 producers and 11 injectors.
After 2 weeks of intensive drilling at well pad 2, the land rig 1 operated by CNOOC with China Oilfield Services Limited, as the lead drilling contractor, has been able to break through the first oil well. This after excavating over 3.5 kilometers underground. Well pad 2 will be used to harvest oil from three wells.
We use water-based mud. This is to help you stabilize the hole and to help you not contaminate the water aquifers that we have closer to the surface. And then, given the nature of the formation that we have, given that we have a bit of clays in the well, we're now using a synthetic-based mud to help us be able to smoothly drill.
Ambrose Ogwang, a drilling engineer at CNOOC Uganda, says their drilling rig is the state-of-the-art, using the latest technology on the market, yet it is environmentally friendly because it is fully automated and soundproof.
And still have a wind of 1 kilometer as a contingency. So this is a state-of-the-art rig. It's using the most recent technology on the market. It was built and constructed in China by COSO, our contractor.
However, oil extraction awaits the pending construction of a central processing facility. Works at the central processing facility have also commenced. Currently, site grading and leveling are underway in preparation for the main work.
We do not necessarily need gas in our oil, so we want to reduce the amount of gas as much as possible, separate it basically. We also want to remove things like rock cuttings and fragments and so on that come from the subsurface.
The Kingfisher Development Project has four well pads and 31 oil wells, of which 20 are producers, while 11 are injectors. CNOOC projects are expected to produce 40,000 barrels of oil per day. The temporary camp has been fully built and occupied by the contractors' teams.
We have the well pad 1. We have the camp where you see white and blue. Okay, we shall go there. And next to the camp, there is the Maram graded area, that is the well pad 1.
In aspects of national content participation, currently, CNOOC Uganda Limited is employing 159 Ugandans, representing 72% of the total employees, while 41 community-based companies that have been awarded contracts worth over 7 billion shillings. In other aspects, oil discovery has transformed lives with new oil roads constructed. CNOOC has also established a clean water plant which serves 5 villages that were facing challenges of sanitation. Support to the health and education facilities has also been realized by UNOC, extending hard-to-reach allowances to medical workers and teachers working in Chikube.
Initially, people used to get water from Lake Albert, and the area suffered many waterborne diseases. But now, this water is well-treated and purified. And the water serves 5 villages in Buhuka area.
This has been confirmed by the chairperson of Nsonga A village in Chikube district, Dismas Maiso, who testified on oil benefits to the villagers. The Petroleum Authority of Uganda is convinced that the current progress is living within Uganda's dream of producing the first commercial oil by 2025. Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news in Chikube District.